Hello friends, this is Yogesh Murungkar. In this video, we are going to talk about some DML queries, and we are going to perform those DML queries by using different operators like operator, then boolean operators and arithmetic operators. Okay, so this is the statement: design and implement database and apply at least 10 DML queries. So for a given input string, display only those records which match the given pattern. So we are also going to use while characters. How to make use of those while characters like percentage and caret sign and dollars. So we are going to see that. So first of all, let us connect to the MySQL database. This is the command to connect to MySQL database. I am going to connect to MySQL database as a root user. That's why sudo MySQL -u root -p. U means user, root is the name of the user, and -p means password. So I am connected to MySQL database. Now if I type show databases, it is going to show me all the databases which are present here. To create my own database, I can type use MyDB. If it is already there, I am going to connect to that particular database. So I have already created a database called as MyDB. So I can connect to that particular database by using use command. If I type show tables, these are the tables. Basically, we are going to perform all these operations on EMP and department table. So it is already there. So again, I will type show tables. So these are the tables which are there in MyDB database. Now I will check the data from EMP table. So select star from EMP. You can see here there are 13 number of rows present. 13 records are there in EMP table. So whatever the questions we are going to solve in this particular file, all those questions will be based on EMP, DPT, bonus and salary table. So display employee name, salary, department number for employees who either work in department 10 or work in department 20. So this is the query to answer that particular question. Select star from EMP, this is the table. So the query to answer that particular question, that is to display employees who are working in department 10 or 20. So you want to display name, salary, all those things. So instead of star means all. Instead of star, we need to display these columns: name, that's why select ename, then salary, that's why comma sal, and then department number, that's why comma department number. So select ename comma sal comma department number from EMP. EMP is the name of the table which we have seen, where we want all the employees from department 10 or department 20. So here department in works like or 10 or 20. So in 10 or 20. So this is the answer for that particular query. Next is display employee name, salary, department number for employees who either work in department 10 or work in department 20 but as a clerk. So there is a little modification in the previous query. We want to find out all the employees in department 10 or 20 but who work as a clerk. So that is the only change in the previous query and this query. So I am just going to add one more condition by using and. So and job is equal to clerk. Job is the name of the column in EMP table. So see, you can see Adams and Miller, these are the two people who are working as clerk either in department 10 or in 20. So you can check the same thing from the table also, from EMP table. So this is how you can write down a query with the help of where clause and by using the operations like and or. So here James is working in department 30 actually, that's why he is not displayed here. He is also working as clerk, but we wanted only those people, only those clerks who are working in department 10 or 20. That's why we got these two people. Next question: display employee name, salary, department number for all employees working in department 10 and having salary greater than 3000 or those who are managers working in department 10 and having salary greater than 3000 or who are managers. So you can check these conditions. We want all these things, their name, salary and department number for people who work in department 10. So that's why we have department number equal to 10 and having salary greater than 3000. So that particular person should be working in department 10 and he should have salary greater than 3000. That's why we can use and. So department number equal to 10 and sal equal to sal greater than 3000. So is there a person with the salary greater than 3000 in department 10? We will have to check it first, because otherwise it is not going to show any result. So we will have to make the change if it is not. Okay, so what I have done, department number equal to 10 and salary greater than 3000, or he should be manager. So, or job equal to manager. So we are going to find out the people who are working in 10 and having salary greater than 3000, or they are working as manager. So we got those four records here. You can check it. James is a manager, Clark is a manager, and then King is a president, but his salary is greater than 3000. That's why his name is there. You can check it, right? So this is how you can write down the answer for that particular query. Next one, display employee name, salary and department number for employees having commission as null. You want to display all the employees whose commission is null. So here you can see COMM column is nothing but the commission column in EMP table. So we want to display their name, salary and department number for the people, for the employees whose commission is null. So select ename, comma sal, comma department number from EMP, where now null value, how to handle null values, we cannot write down equal to, so we will have to write down commission is null. So see, these are the people who are having commission as null. You can check it from here also. So Jones, commission null, then Blake, commission null. So all these people, they are having commission as null. Next one, this is the same thing but for the employees for whom the commission is not null. So we just want need to add one word, that is not. So commission is not null. So these are the people who are not having commission as null. So you can check it. Alan is not having commission as null. Then Ward is not having commission as null. Next one, Martin not having commission as null. And Turner also, he is also not having commission as null. That's for four records. Next query. Display employee name, salary and department number for employees whose name starts with A. Now here we are going to use while characters. We want to display all these things for the people whose name starts with A. So how to make a use of while character, that's what we are going to see here. So select ename, comma sal, comma department number from EMP, where ename like starts with A, that's why A percentage. Okay, so Ellen and Adams, these are the two people whose name is starting with A. So you should note that particular thing, we should write it down in single quote, A percentage in single quote. Okay, so that was the query to find out name. Now next one, we want to display the things whose name contains second character as A. So for that, this is the answer. Just add underscore and then A and then percentage will match to all the things. That was the query for this seventh question. Now eighth one, for employees whose name ends with A, we want to display same things but for only those employees whose name is ending with A. So just write down percentage, that is all, and then A. So there is no person whose name is ending with A. You can check it. There is no employee whose name is ending with A. So we can try it for some other character if you want. So for example, you can change that particular question ending with A to ending with R. So I will have to make the change in my query. Just type R and see Turner and Killer. So both the names are ending with R. So this is how you can display the result for the people whose name ending with R, whose salary is between 2000 and 4000. So we want to display the same things for the people whose salary is between those two salaries. So how to write down that particular query? So sal between 2000 and 4000, right? So we use operator called as between, or a keyword called as between. So this is the query. Between inclusive both, okay? Then whose name contains some character, okay? We want to display the employee name, salary and department number for all employees whose name contains this particular character. So you can write it down like this, percentage and percentage. Okay, so this is how you can write down all these queries. It's very easy. So I am going to provide that document also. That's it. Thank you very much. Thanks a lot.